So in this part, we're going to focus on webhooks and creating your first webhook. So in this one, I already went with the Aha Moment Labs bot that I built, and I could show you what that looks like real quick. Here it is. And right now you wouldn't be able to play with it because it isn't open to the public. It's just open to me. And basically it is the Parrot bot that we've been working on. And anytime you write something like, hi, what happens is the server receives this and it sends it right back to you. It parrots it back to you. So as you can see, boom, it just came back and it said hi, and I got a notification up here in the top right hand corner. Now if we did aha like this, what happens is a little different. Since aha is a keyword phrase that we're using, the chatbot comes back with cards, and these cards are made available again by Facebook. And throughout the Facebook documents, they show you how to structure these cards and they give you the code to do it. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this go live. We're creating exactly this Parrot app. So next thing we need to do is we need to come back to Messenger and set up our first webhook. And now it's very simple to do. First thing is you want to come over here and you want to select a page. So in our case, it's Aha Moment Labs, and it'll give you a page access token. So you want to copy that. And it's copied, so I don't want to make this totally available to the world. And you want to come over here and you want to paste it somewhere. So in our case, that's our code. So once we have that, we want to come in here and we want to create a webhook. So you want to set up a webhook, and I'm going to show you what that looks like. So it's very simple. Set up webhook. So now we know that's going to ask us two main things: verify token and a callback URL. So our verify token is actually in our code, and let me show you where that is. So if you want to go back to the code and come on to line 21, it is Aha Moment Labs. That is our verify token. I also wrote it down here, our verify token. So you want to copy and paste this in here so it'll look like this. You want to select all of these options. And then you want to get your callback URL. Now, the way to get the callback URL is by logging into Heroku. Once you've logged into Heroku, and here's Heroku, you go to the dashboard and you go to your apps. So since you've been pushing, since you've already pushed this app out to Heroku, it should be here. So you find the app. If you have two of them and you don't know which one it is, and if one of them has DZs on it, it means it's asleep. So it's definitely not that one. So you select the app. Once you're on the app page, you want to select open app. It'll open it up for you, and this is your domain name. Now to get the webhook is very simple. You just add a webhook at the end of this. Right? Webhook. I wrote it down here as well. So you want to copy that. Come back to Facebook. Enter it as the callback URL. And then you want to verify and save. Now, since I've already done this, I won't do this again. Instead, I'll just take you to the appropriate page. It's going to say complete. So let me show you what this event looks like. If I go to edit, you could see I have all these things checked off. Now, you could look at them: message deliveries, message postbacks, messages, message account linking, message options, right? And some of these things Facebook provides code-wise. So thanks for watching. And next, we're going to go over the page access token and what to do with it.